Today, sorry, I'm gonna move a little bit away from the desk. specializing on any one flower type and skipping over valuable ones that are encountered in root is not a strategy to maximize energy intake per unit time. Fair enough. That's a fair perspective to look at through, like, insect biologists. So bugs don't live a long time, so they have to make good use of the time that they're here. That's just a particular strategy of looking at stages of life in an insect world. A resolution between these two schools of thought seems to be this. Okay. If insects visit only a single flower species, such flower constancy clearly involves learning. Okay, so they think that they think they're learning. Kill. If an insect visits more than one species, or more than one single species, this can mean that it remembers all the species involved or was able to remember none of the species. Fair enough. If these two possibilities are distinguishable, insects can skillfully locate the name of the flowers of distant species rather than randomly choosing is testable. Oh, okay, so they think that they can tell when a flower is related and go to that one if it has resources. Cool, cool. I think the point of this paper is really to try to, like, predict where certain insects will go to, like, forage, I guess. So that way they can, like, try to attract certain species, make sure that they have enough food, especially for bees, because I learned in class that bees are down 30%, and that's not ideal, so. This is a yogurt mask that my mom gave me. I think it's a philosophy one. She has good taste. Oh, so wonderful. It's really just like a moisturizer, but another quick skin massage would be real good sound for ASMR, GaySMR. So I got GaySMR on Google, and then I forgot the login. So that happened. That's always wonderful. But we're here. So things just work out, I guess. So that's for you. Sounds going on. Also sensitive to interference. If honeybees are given two subsequent love learning trials in quick succession with two novel different odors and colors, the memory for the first stimulus can be effectively erased. I like that green. That sounds like they did an experiment to prove that. Oh, yeah. Well, citation number 28 did an experiment to prove that. We conclude that two novel sensory stimuli cannot be simultaneously held in short-term memory. Strategy to work, bees must remember the direction of arrival at a flower. Understandably, this information is not short in the long-term memory for the hundreds of thousands of flowers visited during a forage bout. Instead, it is replaced rapidly as the bee moves along its foraging path. Note, however, that when bees forage extensively and for long periods of time, it is a single floral array. The rough geometry of the foraging flight may become increasingly Constancy may be a part of an effect of the temporal limitations on basically they're saying bees. So what they're getting at in this paper is they believe that bees go from one flower to the next, and if there is a they Some studies bees were reluctant to switch in the first several seconds of flight after a flower visit, even if alternative options were available and familiar. This suggests that a temporal constraint of retrieving rote memories from the long-term memory. Experience bees, however, sometimes switch very rapidly or very readily between species, particularly if they have visited several floral types. They can therefore they can juggle the necessary information efficiently. Is really light. It's really, really, really light compared to other rocks. Amber is fossilized resin, and a good example of a resin of a tree is actually honey from bees. Alrighty. That was almost vague, but it wasn't really. Okay. We do not fully understand these differences, but one explanation may be search among several parameters such as color and pattern is more time consuming. One explanation may be that search among several parameters such as color and pattern is more time consuming than a search for a single parameter. Oh, he's gonna make a smoothie. Oh, I gotta go turn. I gotta be ready. Oh, he's just making a drink. I'm terrified. Is happening right when I'm doing the video because that's my luck. I'm so scared of it happening, but it hasn't yet. But it might. The causes of consistency may lie only in the difficulties of simultaneously accessing all information stored in a pollinator's memory, but also in the difficulty of acquiring complete information about the quantity of flowers in the outside world. Sometimes it's better not to risk it for the biscuit. Inevitably. Well, and that really works for bees too, because there's so many foragers. They're gonna get, like, one of them is gonna get something good. And it works good for plants too, because then the plants are being pollinated and they're not cross-pollinating with other, like, plant species. Well, bees, I think that works pretty well. Fascinating. One flower. Is could be beneficial. Development. sales.